Hello students, in this video we are going to introduce about the Python application programming, the open elective subject for the year 21-22 that is provided by the Computer Science and Engineering Department. Two course instructors are handling Python application programming subject, Pearl Alice Lobo, Assistant Professor, Computer Science and Engineering Department, Pragnayam, Assistant Professor, Computer Science and Engineering Department. So what is Python application programming? Python application programming is a general purpose interpreted high level programming language with dynamic semantics. So Python is interpreted language because it goes through an interpreter which turns code you write into a language understood by your computer's processor. Why Python application programming? It has rich set of libraries and frameworks. It is a collection of packages or modules that allow developers to write web applications or services. Flexibility, because it was not originally created to answer a specific need, Python is not derived by templates or specific APIs and is therefore well suited for rapid development and for all kinds of applications. Simple and consistent, easy to learn syntax, it is readability and therefore reduces the cost of program maintenance. Platform independent, it means Python can run equally easily on a variety of platforms like Windows, Linux, Unix and many more. Huge community and popularity, it is easy to understand by humans. Python now ranks as the third most widely used programming language worldwide with a rating of 12.21%.
Next is why Python for civil engineers. For reinforced concrete structure, Python can be used to design reinforced concrete design structures. Since it is user-friendly, anyone without the knowledge of programming can start working with Python to design interactive reinforced concrete structures. Next is for civil engineers, there are libraries such as NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, with which you can do data interpretation, statistics, numerical analysis. NumPy can be used to perform calculations on multidimensional arrays. Matplotlib can be used for shape sensational graphics. Pandas can be used to access MS Excel and manipulate large amount of data and even perform numerical reasoning problems. Next is applications of data science in civil engineering. Applications such as population forecasting for urban planning, water supply, and sewage system. Predicting traffic trends in highway engineering, risk assessment and mitigation such as prediction of floods, earthquakes, and cyclones. Next is why Python for mechanical engineers. For numerical analysis, the most popular application of Python is to perform numerical analysis. When problems like linear equation and ODE or PDE are involved, it would take a long time to solve the problems. In terms of mechanical engineering, there are usually boundary conditions present, which make it twice harder to solve numerical analysis problem. But by using built-in libraries and function, it is easy to do numerical analysis. In the field of computational fluid dynamics, Python has a massive application. In order to simulate problems in CFD software, you will be required to write your scripts in programming language like Python. Mechanical and automobile industries use Python to automate tasks. As you all know, recent days, all the manual tasks are done by automation tasks for the test prediction. So by using automation tasks written in the Python language, we can automatically predict that whether the task is successful or unsuccessful before the release of the product. Next, Python is used in other areas of mechanical engineering like vibration and dynamic motion, simulation and modeling engineering, etc. Next is why Python for electronics engineers and electrical engineers. For signal processing and image processing, there are some built-in libraries with which you can easily do the signal and image processing. Next is control system engineering. Next is data visualization. We can visualize the data and predict the outcomes by using some libraries. Next, embedded system. By using Python programming, we can embed some program in the embedded system easily without any hardware system problem. Next is controlling and automatic test equipment. We can, rather than doing manual test, we can automatically test all the test cases. Next is automation in file processing. As you all know, when any of the chip is released in this market, the different vendors will be having different kind of Excel sheet. And we understand that we need to read different kind of, we need to find different in the internet, and then we should read those. But by using few libraries and some simple Python code, it's possible to change text files and to multiple formats, and which is common to all the files. Course learning objective. Learn syntax and semantics and create functions in Python. Handle strings and files in Python. Understand lists, dictionaries, and regular expressions in Python. Implement object-oriented programming concepts in Python. Build web services and introduction to network and database programming Python. Thank you. Thank you.